In this video, we're going to talk about examples in using the Z table. Each Z table has a small standard normal curve picture next to it to identify which table you're using. Sometimes you'll be seeing a standard normal picture that looks like this. In this case, it's telling us that it shades from the population mean of 0 outward, in this case to the right. Sometimes you'll see a standard normal curve that looks something like this, which says that you start over here from the left and then you shade to the right. Or you might have this other picture where it says, in this case, the shading starts from the right and it goes to the left. Depending on which picture you have, that corresponds to a particular table. In this video, we are not going to be doing the last two. So that means that the table that I'm going to be using has this graph. Okay. All right. So that's one thing that we need to consider. The next thing is, how do we read the table? Okay, so we're going to get z-scores, something like this. Z is equal to 1.47. Not in particular, because it needs to be in a range or some inequality or something, but bear with me. So let's say you have z equals 1.47, and we want to know where that's located on the table. Okay, we have to think of 1.47. Think of it as money. Now, I know money has nothing to do with the standard normal, but bear with me again. It's going to help us to understand how to read this table. So if this is like $1.47, we have the ones, or the unit place. We have the tenths, you know, the 10 cents, the 20 cents, the so forth. And then the hundredths place, you know, that's kind of like the penny, you know, one penny, two pennies, three pennies, right? Because it's a hundredths of a dollar. Now, just keep thinking with me here. So think of $1.47, right? Okay, so how do you translate in the table? Well, it turns out the hundredths place, right? The 1 cent, 2 cent, 3 cent, 4 cent is located in here on the table in red. You can see that. It says, right here, one penny, two pennies, four pennies, and so forth. Think of it that way. And then the ones and the tenths place is here in this column. So over here is 20 cents, and over here is 70 cents, and over here is $1.30, right? And over here is $2, and so forth. Okay, so how do you do this 1.47, right? Which is $1.47. Well, the first thing we want to do is think of $1.40. So where's $1.40? Here on the Z table, on the column that's written in red, right? $1.47, but we need to look at $1.40. Where is that? Yes, right there. So let's draw a line going across. It's an orange. So in this case, everything that's in orange, right? We can see that this square would be $1.40, $1.41, $1.42. How do I know it's $1.42? that square in particular, because it points to 2 cents, right? So it's $1.42. So the value, right? $1.47. We found $1.40. We need 7 cents. Well, there it is. 7 cents is over here. So we draw another orange line, and boom. Where do they cross? They cross at $1.47. So let's find the area under the standard normal curve. Now we know standard normal has a population mean of 0 and a population standard deviation of 1. You'll see that these examples are not word problems. They're just the standard normal, and we have a shaded portion which we want to know the probability. In this case, the z-score, we want to know what the probability of the z-score being larger than 2.87. So first we need to do is we need to look at 2.87. And again, we'll think of it as money, $2.87. So we need to look at $2.80, right? 2.8, $2.80. And that's that particular row, 2.8. And then the 7 cents, which is right there, right? And where do they cross? They cross right there at 0.49795. Okay, so that number that we found is an area, right? 0.49795. That's the area of what? Well, it turns out it's the area from the mean to the beginning of the orange piece, because the table, remember, is shaded starting from the mean to the right. Okay, so that's 0.4980. So what's the orange piece? Well, we know from 0 all the way to the right is half, or 0.5, right? 0, 0, 0. So how do we figure out the orange piece? Well, we need to subtract those two values, and we get 0.002. So the probability, z being greater than or equal to 2.87, is equal to 0.002. All right, let's try another one. Find the area under the standard normal curve again. This time, we see that we want to know, again, the shaded portion. It seems like the shaded portion is between 0 and 1.36. Let's look for 1.36. Think of it as $1.36. So we need to look at $1.30 first. And there it is. There's $1.30. And then we think of 6 cents, right? And where does it cross? It crosses right there. So 0.41308. is the area, okay? Which area? Well, it turns out to be that particular area, the area in the orange. So that's the answer. So what does this mean? So we were looking for the probability that z, right? Z is, the value of z is between 0 and 1.36, right? And the probability of that is equal to 0.4131. Okay, let's try another one. Okay, same situation. We have a drawing. It looks like something like this. So we're wondering, where do we start? We'll start with the z-scores. Start with -1.21. Okay, let's look it up in the table. Right, so think of it as $1.21. Now, forget about the negative. Why? Because the table's symmetrical. There are no negative z scores in the table, but the table is symmetrical. So 1.21 is what we need to think about, okay? So $1.21, again, $1.20, where is that? Put it in red, and then 1 cent from the top, and there it is. This is the answer. 0.38686. Okay, so that is the area from 0 to negative 1.21, which is 0.3869. Okay, now let's look at that value, negative 2.01. Think of it again, forget about the negative. Think of 2.01 as $2.01. So there's $2, and then let's think of 1 cent. And there's the value right there that you want. Okay, fine. So from negative 2.01 all the way to zero, the area is 0.4778. And now we have to figure out what the area of the orange piece is. Well, it turns out that you need to subtract those pieces to get you the orange piece. So in this case, we wanted to know what the probability was of negative 2.01 less than or equal to z less than or equal to negative 1.21, right? And that was going to be equal to 0.0909. Okay, let's try one more. Again, we're going to draw it, and we're going to figure out what the area is. Okay, so in this case, let's look at 1.23, right? Think of it again as $1.23. Let's find the area. So what do? 1.2, okay, or again, $1.23, right? Let's look at $1.20, which is 1.2. There's the red line, and then think of 3 cents, right? And then that is going to be our area, okay? So that orange piece from 0 to 1.23 is going to be 0.3907. And then let's look at negative 0.16. Again, we don't have to worry about the negative. Why? First of all, we don't have a table that has negative z-scores, but our curve is a symmetrical. So 0.16 is 16 cents. So we have to look for 10 cents and then 6 cents. Where's 10 cents? Right there. And then 6 cents, which is right there in the green. And there's the answer right there. Okay, let's take that. And then that orange piece is going to be 0.0636. Now we're going to have to think, what do we do with this information? Well, that orange piece, those two orange pieces, we have to add them together to give me the total probability. So in this case, I wanted to look at the probability of negative 0.16 less than or equal to z less than or equal to 1.23, which is equal to 0.4543.